السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. This is Dr. Louis Faisal from Jihan University Sulaymaniye. This is the second exercise for the computer science students fourth year. As a matter of fact, I have already explained the theoretical part inside the lecture, so this is just about explaining the practical part. As you can see here, our second exercise about connecting many servers to our network. So this is we took this network, the small part here. We have already took it in the first exercise, and second exercise I'm connected to other switch. So since both switches are second layer and same layer, so we use crossover cable, and I will connect the second switch with four type of servers. The first server is DHCP server, which is Dynamic Host Control Protocol. This is responsible for giving dynamic IP address for first PC and the second PC. About the third PC, it will have a static IP address. I will enter it manually, just distinguish between the first PC and second PCs. As a matter of fact, you can add many PCs as you wish. For the third and second server is DNS server, domain name system. It works as a translator, so it translates websites, which is connected website servers to IP address, and vice versa, IP address to websites. So I have a website, other website, and I have a mail server. So about the website, it depend on HTTP server. HTTP is hypertext transfer protocol, and the other one is email server. So I will create this network step by step, just follow me please. For the first network, as I have explained before, we need three computers, 1, 2, 3. Then I need four servers, 1, 2, 3, 4. I need two switches for this exercise. I choose my switch from here, 1, 2. Then I connect my network, crossover cable for switches, and straight through for PC to switch. It's very important to mention that a NAT, network address translator networks, are three types. I will write down the three types of NAT in here. It is mentioned that the first network from 192.168.0.0 to 192.168.255.255. We have used this network in the previous exercise. Accordingly, I will not use it now. I will use the second exercise, and number of users can be 2 to the power of 20 for the second NAT. As we have agreed before, I will assign DHCP dynamic IP address here, so I need to use the DHCP. For the second PC, I use also a DHCP server. Then I close it. For the last PC, I will assign a static IP address. So, as static IP address, we have to add 172.16.0.90. I will start counting from 90 here for this exercise. Accordingly, I have to check if we have a gateway. I will assign default gateway, which is 1, and then DNS server. I will assign DNS server for my network. This is will start from 11. I choose 11 just randomly. Then, to not forget this number, I will just copy it and I will add it in here. These are my servers. I will add my IP address in here, and I will assign other IP address for my DHCP server, and I will assign other IP address for my website, which is patrolv.12, other IP address for mail, which is 13. As you can see here, I can change the name to DHCP by click on it and just activate it, and this is DNS server, and this is gonna be www.sulijihan.edu.krd. and this is gonna be my email, mail.sulijahan.edu.krd, sulijahan.edu.krd. Now I start to configure my DHCP server. I will go to configuration setting. I will assign my gateway, and then the DNS server, then go to the fast Ethernet. I will assign my IP address, as you can see here. Then I'll go to services. I have to make sure that the HTTP is off and email is off. Then DNS is off also. Then you go to DHCP and make it on. Keep the pool name same. We don't need to change it. Just change the gateway and change the DNS as well. You see, as we have agreed before, I have assigned an IP address for static device starting from 90. Accordingly, I will give the other dynamic IP addresses, make it start from 100. You can choose 120 as you wish. And maximum number of users, I will make it 255, and I will save my details in here. Accordingly, now I have DHCP fully activated. I will connect my DHCP server to my network. Now it's connected. Give it about 1 minute to activate the IP addresses, and give an IP address which is different than what is given here. You may notice that it's given 169. Just give it 1 minute. This 169 will be changed to 100, and this is gonna be 101, because we start our DHCP server to be counting from IP address dynamically from 100 and 101. I'll go to configure my DNS server. For my DNS server, go to setting, assign the gateway, make sure it's correct. And then go to fast Ethernet. This is my DNS server, and go to services, set down the HTTP and email, and go to DNS. DNS is just translator, so write your website which you are about to translate it. This is my website, so www.sulijahan.edu.krd. Then my IP address is going to be 12. Add. Go to the next network. mail.sulijahan.edu.krd, and assign an IP address for this one, .13, and save it. Okay. There is a problem. Just add. Sorry, not save it. That's it. Close this window. Now the DNS server is connected already. It's configured already, so we just have to connect it. Connect it to your switch. Now the server is connected, so I will just put my mouse on the first PC. As you can see here, my fast Ethernet app, and the IP address is 172.16.0.100. The other dynamic IP address is 172.16.0.101. That's mean my network is connected and everything is functional. Can we add another PC just to try that DHCP is working? Just put the PC and you can connect it to your network like this. Give it a time. You will notice that the DHCP, the fast Ethernet, will change soon, but before it changed, you have to change the configuration to DHCP. So this is dynamic, so the server will give an IP address. Meanwhile, I will connect the other PCs. This is an HTTP server, so I have to make the configuration. This is the gateway, and this is the server. And go to fast Ethernet, give the static IP address, which is 12, and that's it. Go to services, make the HTTP is on, make the email is off, and go back to HTTP. So this is a default website. Can we change this default? The answer is yes. I will say welcome to Dr. Louis Faisal class. and save it. We have saved the chains. That's it. I'll try to access to the server, but before that I have to connect it. I've connected to my network. I will confirm that the three PCs have as dynamic IP addresses. Make sure everything is connected correctly. That's it. I'll try to access to this server. Before that, I'll try to make sure the other servers are connected. This is for the DNS. As you see, it's connected successfully. I'll send another message to the DHCP. It's also connected successfully. Now I'll try as an exercise, I'll try to ping my website. Ping 172.16.0. As you may notice that my website is .12, so that means the HTTP server is already connected. I will make sure that DNS is working, so I'll change this IP address to www.solidham.edu.krd. Then you see directly the DNS is working. It understood that this website has the following IP address and is connected already. I will do another exercise. I will open the website. So as you may notice that this is what the web browser, this is my application. I will make www.solijahan.edu.krd and go. You see, welcome to Dr. Luay Faisal class. So that means my HTTP is working already, and the third part of our lecture is done already. I will try to send an email. Before that, I'll make sure the configurations are correct in here. So this is the DNS. I will put the static IP address for the mail server. This is my static IP address. I will start from 13, as you remember here. Then I'll go to services. I'll make the HTTP off. I will go to my email. I make it on. Choose the domain name. It's very important to put this domain name same as you have assigned for your exercise. So my domain name is mail.solijahan.edu.krd. Now start to put the users and password. User 1, and my password will be 123. Add then user 2, and my password will be 123. Add and user 3, my password is 123. Add and user 4, my password gonna be 123. And add. So now it should be already activated. I will connect it to my network. Give it about 1 minute to be activated and connected to your network. I'll try to make sure that we have connection in the progress field, because it's not connected yet. As you can see, the signal is orange. I'll start a new session. Till connected, I will configure my email for the first PC. Go to email, go to config your email. This is about incoming mail server. So my username is user1 for the first PC, and email will be user1@mail.solijahan.edu.krd. Copy this thing and just paste it here to make it fast. This is the outgoing mail server, and now your username is user1, the password is 123, and save it. Go to the second PC, do the same mail configuration. So this is going to be user2, then user2@mail.cdg.edu.com, and then the email is like this, and then the outgoing mail server will be like this. Regarding the login information, I will write the address user 2, 1, 2, 3, save, and this third user, go to this store, mail service, configure your email like this, this is user 3. User 3, and then the incoming mail server is, the outgoing mail server is, then user 3, 1, 2, 3, save. Now close this one, go to the fourth user, go to mail configuration, this is user 4, and this is the email address, is for this is the incoming mail server, and this is the outgoing mail server, and this is user 4, and this is 1, 2, 3, save. Now I'll try to send an email from PC0 to PC3. Go to email, go to compose. I'm at user 1, I'll send to user 3. Subject is hi, this is my first email, and send it. There is a problem. If server is not found, we can just do like a very common problem may happen, that we forgot to assign a mail server. So go back to your mail server, go to the services, go to email, you'll see that the domain name is not set yet, so make sure to assign the domain name. Domain name will be mail.surijahan.edu.krd, then set this one. It had been set. Now we can send an email normally. Compose from user 1 to user 3, first email, and say hi, send it. Now there is no problem, the message has been sent from user 1 and received at user 3 like this. Thank you very much for watching this video. I hope it will be very useful and benefited for all my students. Thank you so much.